I'm going to tell you just a little about the background that I came from. I'm not a doctor, I'm not an Arab, I'm not a lawyer, I'm a slave. And that's why I took the name Abdullah, the slave to Allah. I actually came from a line of preachers and teachers. They went back to a man by the name William David Chappelle. He was actually a slave who was bought and sold. I was the first Muslim in my family, but today there are 25 Muslims in my family. Nobody in my family learned this, or rather accepted Islam from my hands. But in my absence, they were reading books and they were learning Islam. And so what I'll tell you is that my brother David, he was the second person to accept Islam in my family. The next person in my family who accepted Islam was my mother. The next person who accepted Islam, I think, was my sister. The next person who accepted Islam in my family was my father. He died the same year. We gave him Janaza Islamia. The other people in my family were impressed. My grandmother said, I want my funeral exactly the same like his. And she died a couple of years after my daddy. But before she died, she accepted Islam. Sometimes we think, we as Muslims, we think that people will solve our problems. And this is not correct.
They say, okay, will you sell your iman for $100?
No,
I won't sell my iman for $100. Will you sell your iman for $1,000?
You think I'm cheap?
Will you sell your iman for $10,000? No. $100,000? No. $1,000,000? Damn, let me think about that. This is the way that shaitan works. But you have to be true to yourself and ask yourself, how much am I worth?
My brother was looking at me at the time, you know, telling me, how is it that I'm rich and famous and you're broke? You have peace of mind and I can't sleep at night.
If people want you to reinforce stereotypes so that they can enslave humanity and they want to use you and your image and your relationship with the people, then you need to think long and hard whether you want that money or not.
I would like to address a topic that I call virtual reality and virtual Muslims. Where Muslims respect Christians and Jews more than they respect their own Muslim brothers and sisters, we have to get away from that thinking. And unless and until we get away from that thinking, the unbelievers will keep us down. So it's time for us to stand up and speak out and defend our rights, our God-given rights. And I will live for it, I will fight for it, and I will die for it. Your Rabb al-Ibadi, wa antashat ruhi.